फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू ऑन द फास्ट ट्रैक डिफेंस चैनल। फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू सीरीज फॉर करंट अफेयर्स एंड दिस करंट अफेयर्स गोइंग टू बी एक्सट्रीमली हेल्पफुल इन NDA एंड CDS एग्जामिनेशन। ऑल ऑफ यू आर अवेयर दैट NDA 1 एंड CDS 1 2022 एग्जामिनेशन विच इज़ गोइंग टू बी हेल्ड ऑन 10th of April 2022 इज एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ईच एंड एवरी एस्पिरेंट। And the role of current affairs is again important role in those two examination. जैसा कि आप सभी को पता है कि NDA और CDS का examination 10th of April को all over India में होने वाला है, और जो current affairs का एक important segment है वो काफ़ी important role play करता है। If we talk about in the exams of NDA and in the exam of CDS, in the exam of NDA around 12 questions and in the exam of CDS around 20 questions are asked from the current affairs. And we are the first channel in the YouTube, we are the first channel to start a current affairs series. So it is a request from all of you to share this video to each and every aspirant, whoever is preparing for the NDA examination, because this current affairs series is going to be extremely helpful to you. अब हम बात करते हैं जो NDA 1 2021 का जो एग्ज़ाम हुआ था और NDA 2 2021 के एग्ज़ाम्स में। इन दिस टू एग्ज़ाम्स 12 questions were asked and from that 12 questions 11 questions came from this channel only, and from these 20 questions 18 questions came from what we taught in this channel only. By the way, before starting the video I would like to tell you one more thing. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe the channel, because in future we are going to cover each and every current affairs part wise, month wise in detail. So if you subscribe the channel, if you come to the playlist, firstly if you see the playlist of current affairs for NDA 2 2021 and CDS 2 2021, in this we covered all the current affairs in part wise, part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4, part 5, part 6, and in the final part, part 7. And all these parts were extremely helpful and questions directly came from these videos only. And if you are in the need of more materials, you can visit the more videos which we have made and made a separate playlist for, like mathematics, statistics, maxima and minima, binomial theorem, limits and all other chapters which are required for the NDA max. So without wasting any time, we'll start with the video, and this video is going to be part one of the current affairs, and in this we are going to discuss the October month current affairs. So friends, without wasting any time, we'll start with the video. So we are going to cover the current affairs in two part. In first part we are going to cover the national current affairs events, and in the second part we are going to cover the international current affairs and events. Before starting the video, I would like to tell you, please share this session to all of your friends, because this current affairs series is going to be extremely helpful, and we have analyzed the previous 14 years of current affairs series and taken only those questions which can come in your examination. Probability of questions from this PDF is going to be come in your examination. So without wasting any time, we'll start with the video, and the first question from the national current affairs is, name the actor who passed away at the age of 82 years. He played the iconic role in the Ravana in the popular TV serial Ramayana, directed by the late Ramanand Sagar. So here the question is, who played the role of Ravana in the TV serial Ramayana and who died recently at the age of 82 years. Then his name was Arvind Trivedi. Here they can ask one more question, who directed the TV serial Ramayana. Then you have to answer Ramanand Sagar. So here two questions will come, first regarding the role play of Ravana and second regarding the director of Ramayana TV serial. So this was the first question. Moving over to the second question, which is appearing on your screen, name the comic book character created by the Pran Kishore Sharma, which has been chosen as the mascot of Namami Ganga program. So Namami Ganga program is a program started by the government of India to clean the river Ganga from the pollution. So this is a comic book character named Chacha Chaudhary. This Chacha Chaudhary character has been named as a mascot of Namami Ganga project. This question is very much important because it is coming under the schemes and initiatives by the government of India. Moving over to the third question, again important question because from the famous personality, name the Tamil film director by filmmaker Vinod Raj PS, who has been selected as India's official entry to the 94th Academy Award, also known as Oscar Award. So basically they are asking, what is the name of the movie which got selected to the Oscar Award from India? So this movie is very much important name. Kulangal is the name of the movie and English meaning is Pebbles. So this movie got selected to the 94th Academy Awards, that is the Oscar award which is given in the category of film. And one more question I would like to ask, name the highest award in terms of film category. Then that answer is Oscar award. Oscar award is the highest award in the film category. Moving over to the next question, what was the theme of Vigilance Awareness Week 2021 that was observed from 26th of October 2021 to 1st of November 2021? So basically any questions coming regarding theme, important days, important events, what are the themes, important personalities, it becomes important. And if you see the trend analysis of UPSC NDA previous year, you will find that most of the themes are asked in the NDA previous year question paper. So here they are asking the theme of Vigilance Awareness Week, which was celebrated in the month of October and November. So the theme was Independent India at the rate 75, self-reliance and integrity. Just you need to remember only two words, self-reliant and integrity. In which option, if you see that self-reliant and integrity is mentioned, you tick that option, that is going to be the right answer. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen. Which team won the Durand Cup football tournament defeating Mohammedan Sporting in the finals? So firstly, they may ask that Durand Cup is related to which of the following sport? Cricket, football, hockey, basketball. Then in that case, we have to tick Durand Cup is related to the football. Which team won Durand Cup 2021? Then that team name is FC Goa. Moving over to the next question, this question is again important because important appointments which are appointed by the Government of India is again important question from the UPSC point of view. Name who has been reappointed as the Governor of Reserve Bank of India. So here the name is Shaktikant Das. If we talk about the Reserve Bank of India, it was formed on 1st of April 1935. Headquarter is in Mumbai. And this Shaktikant Das has been appointed for the second time as the Governor of Reserve Bank of India. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen. Name the Kannada actor who passed away on October 29, 2021 due to cardiac arrest at the age of 46. So basically, they are asking who is the Kannada actor who died recently due to cardiac arrest on 29th of October 2021. Then he is Puneet Rajkumar. And why this question is important? Because he has done a lot to the humanity. He run a lot of old age homes and also the orphanages for the betterment of the society. So this question becomes very much important. The Kannada actor who died recently. Remember the name Puneet Rajkumar. Moving over to the next question. Which state or union territory has decided to resume Mukhyamantri Tirth Yatra Yojana? This question becomes very much important because here the UT of Delhi has decided to resume the Mukhyamantri Tirth Yatra Yojana under the government of Delhi. So it is a kind of government initiative, you can think. And just remember, the Union Territory of Delhi has started to resume the Mukhyamantri Tirth Yatra Yojana. Moving over to the next question. The Dearness Allowance, DDA, which is given to the government officials in our country for the central government employee, which has been hiked from 2021 July. Now the Dearness Allowance is 31%. So it has been hiked by 3%. Earlier the Dearness Allowance was 21% and now it has become 31%. So it has increased by 3%. So basically they are asking by how much percentage Dearness Allowances has increased. Then your answer is 3%. Moving over to the next question, this question becomes very much important because it is coming from the sports point of view. And if you open the previous year question of NDA and CDS, you would find that at least two questions are asked from the sports. So here they are asking, name the former Indian cricketer who has applied for the post of head coach of Indian cricket team. Then answer is Rahul Dravid. He is known by the name The Wall. The Wall is a title given to Rahul Dravid, and he became the new coach of India, Team India, after Ravi Shastri resigned. Moving over to the next question, which is coming on your screen. On which date 18th ASEAN India Summit was held? So 18th ASEAN India Summit was held on 28th of October 2021. Now I would like to ask one more question. Where is the headquarter of ASEAN and how many countries are there in the ASEAN? And which trade agreement is between ASEAN country and China? Then the answer to the first question is the headquarter of ASEAN is in Jakarta and the trade agreement which is between ASEAN countries and China, which India have not decided to be in that trade agreement. The name of the trade agreement is RCEP. RCEP is the name of the trade agreement which China and ASEAN countries have signed, and the full form of RCEP is Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. And how many countries are there in the ASEAN? 10 countries are there in the ASEAN and the headquarters is in Jakarta. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen. In which state 6 persons were found infected with the new COVID AY.4? So this is the name of the new COVID variant AY.4, and 6 persons were found infected for the first time in the state of Madhya Pradesh. Moving over to the next question. Next question is very much important, because if you talk about any awards, any award given to any of the important personalities become important. And if you talk about the Dada Saheb Phalke Award is the highest film award in the country of India. Who has been conferred the 51st Dada Saheb Phalke Award in India? He is the actor Rajinikanth from Kollywood. He has also made so many Bollywood as well as Kollywood movies. And if you talk about who won the 50th Dada Saheb Phalke Award, then he is Big B of Bollywood, that is Amitabh Bachchan. Amitabh Bachchan won the 50th Dada Saheb Phalke Award, and 51st Dada Saheb Phalke Award is won by Rajinikanth. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen. Who won the Best Actress Award at 67th National Film Award? So the Best Actress was given to Kangana Ranaut. One more question regarding Kangana Ranaut is that which actress won Padma Shri Award in 2021? So the only actress to get Padma Shri Award in 2021 was again Kangana Ranaut. Moving over to the next question. Who won the Best Actor Award at the 67th National Film Award? So Kangana Ranaut won the Best Actress Award, and the Best Actor Award was given to Manoj Bajpayee and Dhanush. Dhanush is from Tamil industry and Manoj Bajpayee is from Bollywood, that is Hindi movie industry. Moving over to the next question. Which two renowned film director will be honored with Satyajit Ray Lifetime Achievement Award at the 52nd International Film Festival of Goa? So here the first question can come like, where the International Film Festival is held in India. So every year International Film Festival in India is held in Goa only. There is no change of venue. Any year it is held in Goa only. So the two renowned film director who will be honored Satyajit Ray Lifetime Achievement Award is Martin Scorsese and Itzhwan Szabo. These two names you have to remember. You can take the screenshot once if you just want to remember for future. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen. Out of 113 countries, what is the rank of India in Global Food Security Index 2021? This question is important because see, if any of the indexes, if any of the ranking is increased by any of the organization, and they may ask what is the rank of India in that particular index. Like here, they are asking what is the rank of India in Global Food Security Index 2021. So in the rank of Global Food Security Index, India ranks 71st out of 113 countries. Few more questions I would like to ask. What is the rank of India in Henley Passport Index 2022? So the rank of India in Henley Passport Index is 83. What is the rank of Human Development Index of India in the year 2021? Then the rank of India is 139. What is the rank of India in ease of doing business? Then the rank of India is 63. What is the rank of India in Global Hunger Index? Then the rank of India in Global Hunger Index is 116. So these are the important rankings which are released by various institutes, and the ranking of India in any of the index becomes very much important. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen. Who has been awarded the 22nd Lal Bahadur Shastri National Award for Excellence for his contribution in the field of medicine and the pandemic awareness? Then 22nd Lal Bahadur Shastri National Award was given to Dr. Randeep Guleria. If I talk about Dr. Randeep Guleria, he is at present the director of AIIMS. AIIMS, the main AIIMS is situated in New Delhi. The headquarters of AIIMS is in New Delhi and he is the director of AIIMS. And if you talk about Lal Bahadur Shastri, the birth anniversary of Lal Bahadur Shastri was 2nd October only. The same birth anniversary of Lal Bahadur Shastri and Mahatma Gandhi is same on 2nd October only. So the 22nd Lal Bahadur Shastri Award for excellence in the contribution of field of medicine and the pandemic was given to Dr. Randeep Guleria, the present director of AIIMS. Moving over to the next question, which team won the 14th edition of Indian Premier League IPL by defeating KKR Kolkata Knight Riders in the final? Then here the answer is Chennai Super Kings. Few more questions I would like to ask. Who was the orange cap in the 14th edition of IPL and who won the purple cap in the 14th edition of IPL? These both question, if you know the answer, put your answers in the comment section. If it will be right, I'll just give a heart to that particular answer. Moving over to the next question, which Indian footballer has broken the Brazilian legend Pele international record? That is, which Indian footballer has broken the record of Brazilian legend Pele in the international goals? So here the answer is Indian football team captain Sunil Chhatri. If I talk about Indian football team captain, one more question can come, like, name the only footballer to get Dhyan Chand Khel Ratna Award. Only footballer to get Dhyan Chand Khel Ratna Award in 2021 was Indian football team captain Sunil Chhatri. And this question will be asked because, see, any question coming from the sportings, from the awards becomes important, and becoming the only person from the particular sport to get award becomes more important. So please remember the name of Sunil Chhatri because it becomes important. Moving over to the next question, which are the two new teams of the Indian Premier League taking the total number of IPL teams in the next season to be 10? So the two new teams in the IPL next season, that is going to be the 15th season of IPL, the two new teams are Ahmedabad and Lucknow. So the total teams will become 10. At present the teams are 8, so if it will be increased to, then it will become 10. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen, who is the owner of Ahmedabad based Indian Premier League franchise? So basically they're asking who is the owner of the new team Ahmedabad, which has come into the IPL of 15th edition. Then their answer is CVC Capital Partners is the owner of the Ahmedabad IPL team. Next question is again very much important because, see, if you are going to give the defense exams like NDA, NCDS and questions from defense will be obviously asked. So name the India's first indigenous aircraft carrier, INS Vikrant. If I talk about INS Vikrant, more than 76% of the parts which are fitted in the INS Vikrant is made in India. So like, even if you are going for SSB, if any topic is coming regarding make in India or manufacturing sector in India, you can give the example of INS Vikrant. And 76% of the parts of INS Vikrant is again made in India. And it has completed the second sea trial and it is believed that by 2020 only it will be inducted into the Indian Navy. And at present India have one more aircraft carrier and the name of that aircraft carrier is INS Vikramaditya, and with one more which will be added, INS Vikrant, it will become 2. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen, what is the rank of India in Henley Passport Index 2021 with the passport holders allowing to travel a visa free of 58 countries around the world? So they are basically asking the Henley Passport Index of India. Just now I told you the Henley Passport Index of India in the year 2022. So in 2021 the ranking was 90, but it has further improved in 2022 to 83. So basically if the question is coming what is the rank of India in Henley Passport Index, you have to tick the answer 83, not 90, because 90 was in the year 2021 and in 2022 the answer is 83. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen, who has topped the Forbes India Rich List 2021 for the 14th consecutive year with a net worth of 92.7 billion dollar. So basically they're asking who is the richest person in our country according to the Forbes list. So the Forbes list prepares a list of person who are the richest in the world, richest in our country. So in India, the richest person with a net worth of $92.7 billion is Mukesh Ambani. Moving over to the next question, which city has been declared as a dementia friendly city? So the city of Kochi, which is situated in the Kerala, has been declared as a dementia friendly city in our country. Moving over to the next question, which state got its third international airport in Kushinagar? See, if you see the importance of Kushinagar, it is very much important because it is only the place of Kushinagar where Gautam Buddha was buried. That means his last rite took place in the city of Kushinagar only. So state of Uttar Pradesh, that is Kushinagar is situated in the state of Uttar Pradesh, and Kushinagar became international airport recently. At present, which state has the highest number of international airport? Then that is the state of Uttar Pradesh. With addition of Kushinagar, it has become six. Now state of Uttar Pradesh has got six international airport in our country. Moving over to the next question, Reserve Bank of India has retained real GDP growth forecast at how much for the financial year 2021-22? So Reserve Bank of India has told that GDP of India will be around 9.5% growth. So GDP of India in the year 2021 will witness 9.5% of growth. This is estimated made by RBI of India. Moving over to the next question, who has won the FIH Men Hockey Player of the Year award? So basically they are asking who won the FIH Men Hockey Player of the Year award. So here the answer is Harmanpreet Singh. Harmanpreet Singh won the FIH Men Hockey Player of the Year, and Gurjeet Kaur, both from Punjab only, they won the Female Hockey Player of the Year award. In the category of male, answer is Harmanpreet Singh, and in the category of female, answer is Gurjeet Kaur. Now I would like to ask one more question. Which medal India won in the year 2020 Tokyo Olympic in the field of hockey? Then the answer is bronze medal. Now I would like to ask one more question. What was the rank of India in 2020 Olympic in terms of medal, and what was the rank of India in the year 2020 Paralympic? If you know the answer, write your answer in the comment section. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen, RBI Monetary Policy Committee has decided to keep the policy repo rate unchanged at what percentage and reverse repo rate unchanged at what percentage? So the first is going to be 4% and the repo rate is going to be 3.5%. This both is demand made by RBI monetary policy. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen, which state has become the first Indian state to begin organized cultivation of cinnamomum? So here they are asking what is the name of the state which became the first state to begin or organized cultivation of cinnamomum? Then the answer is Himachal Pradesh. Few more questions I would like to ask. Name the first state in India to be fully vaccinated with the COVID-19. Then the answer is Himachal Pradesh. Name the first district in India to be fully vaccinated with the COVID-19. Then the answer is Kinnaur, district of Himachal Pradesh. First union territory to be fully vaccinated with the COVID-19. Then the answer is Andaman and Nicobar Union Territory was fully vaccinated with the COVID-19. So the next question, which is appearing on your screen, is the world's largest Khadi national flag was inaugurated in which Union Territory on 2nd of October 2021? Then the answer is Ladakh. But this record was broken recently in the year January 2022. Now the largest Khadi national flag of our country was hoisted in the state of Rajasthan and in the district of Jaisalmer. So this question you have to remember, chances are very high to be come in the your NDA examination. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen, which Bollywood actress has been named as the brand ambassador of Uttar Pradesh One District One Product Scheme? Like here, question can come in one more way. लाइक वन डिस्ट्रिक्ट वन प्रोडक्ट स्कीम इज रिलेटेड टू विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेट, उत्तर प्रदेश, मध्य प्रदेश, अरुणाचल प्रदेश, हिमाचल प्रदेश, देन दैट केस योर आंसर इज गोइंग टू बी उत्तर प्रदेश. सो हियर द ब्रांड एम्बेसडर ऑफ वन डिस्ट्रिक्ट वन प्रोग्राम स्कीम वॉज कंगना रनौत अगेन, एंड द ओनली बॉलीवुड एक्ट्रेस टू गेट पद्मश्री अवार्ड इन द ईयर 2022 वॉज अगेन कंगना रनौत. With this, we have completed the national current affairs and events, and now we are going to start the international current affairs and events. So, this international current affairs and events is going to be very much important for your NDE examination, and we have taken only those questions for which chances are surely that it will come in your examination. We have analyzed the previous 14 years of current affairs. So, if you watch this lecture completely till the end, you will be in a position to solve most of the questions which is coming in your NDA paper on 10th of April. And don't forget to share this session to each and every one of them, because we are the first channel to start the current affairs series, and we are going to complete entire current affairs in a particular time. So without wasting any time, we'll start with the international current affairs and events. So the first question is, which country won 2020 Thomas Cup Badminton Championship for men, defeating China in the final? So basically they are asking which team won 2020 Thomas Cup. So 2020 Thomas Cup was won by Indonesia. Here question can come in one more way, like Thomas Cup is related to which of the following sport? Then answer is badminton. And what is the capital of Indonesia? Capital of Indonesia is Jakarta. And where is the headquarter of ASEAN? ASEAN stands for Association of Southeast Asian Nation. It is a group of 10 countries, Association of Southeast Asian Nation, and the headquarter of Association of Southeast Asian Nation is in Jakarta, the capital of Indonesia. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen. Which country won the South Asian Football Federation Championship, defeating Nepal in the final? So the country of India won South Asian Football Championship. Country of South Asian took part in the football championship. That football championship was won by India, defeating Nepal in the finals. Next question is, on which day United Nations Day is observed? All of you are aware that UN was formed on 24th of October 1945. So from then onwards, 24th of October is celebrated as United Nations Day. And the same 24th of October is celebrated in India as National Consumers Day. If they ask when National Consumer Day is celebrated, on 24th of October only, National Consumer Day is celebrated in our country. Moving over to the next question, which country won 2020 Uber Cup Badminton Championship, defeating Japan in the final? Then answer is China. Uber Cup was won by China and Thomas Cup was won by Indonesia. And Uber Cup is also related to the game of badminton. Thomas Cup is also related the game to the badminton. So Uber Cup was won by China. Moving over to the next question, name the jailed Russian opposition leader who has been chosen to be awarded the European Union highest award for human rights, Skazarov Award of Freedom of Thought 2021. Then the answer is Alexei Navalny. Alexei Navalny is the major opposition leader to the present Russian president Vladimir Putin. So he won the European Union highest award for human rights, Skazarov Award of Freedom of Thought 2021, Alexei Navalny of Russia. Moving over to the next question, according to the announcement made by CEO Mark Zuckerberg, what will be the new name of Facebook? So the new name of Facebook is Meta, full name is Metaverse. Full name of Meta is Metaverse, and this is the new name of Facebook. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen, which city is hosting the 16th G20 summit from October 30 to October 31, 2021? So the 16th G20 summit was held on Rome in Rome on 30th and 31st October 2021. So here any particular event which is held in any of the particular city becomes important. Like they may ask, where was the recently BRICS summit held, recently ASEAN summit held, recently G20 meeting was held, COP26 meeting. So if any of the particular important meetings are held in the particular place, those meetings become important. So here the 16th G20 summit in the year 2021 in the month of October was held in Rome. Rome is the capital of Italy. Moving over to the next question, गूगल डॉडल सेलिब्रेटेड जापान्स प्रोफेसर कानो जिगोरो विथ अ डॉडल ऑन 28th of October 2021 ऑन द ओकेशन ऑफ हिज 161st बर्थडे. ही इज नोन एज फादर ऑफ विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्पोर्ट्स. सो बेसिकली दे आर आस्किंग कानो जिगोरो. कानो जिगोरो इज नोन एज फादर ऑफ विच स्पोर्ट. देन ही इज नोन एज फादर ऑफ जूडो इन जापान. एंड गूगल डॉडल सेलिब्रेटेड हिज 161st बर्थडे बाई गूगल डोडल. मूविंग ओवर टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. विच कंट्री इज द ओनली वन टू हैव वन ICC मेन T20 वर्ल्ड कप मोर देन वंस. देन इट इज द कंट्री ऑफ वेस्ट इंडीज विच हैज वन द ICC T20 वर्ल्ड कप मोर देन वंस इन द ईयर 2021. ऑल्सो वेस्ट इंडीज ओनली वन. मूविंग ओवर टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. अफ्रीकन यूनियन हैज सस्पेंडेड विच कंट्री आफ्टर मिलिट्री कू. सो अफ्रीकन यूनियन इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ अफ्रीकन कंट्रीज. इट हैज सस्पेंडेड द कंट्री ऑफ सूडान and the capital of Sudan is Khartoum. Like in geography, one more questions can come. Like if you talk about the Nile River, which is considered as the largest river in the world. So the Nile River is made up of two river. One is White Nile and another one is Blue Nile. This White Nile and Blue Nile meet at a place of capital of Sudan, that is Khartoum, and from where it is known as Nile River. So this is the important point from the geography point of view. So African Union has suspended the country of Sudan because Sudan turned into a military coup. Moving over to the next question. Name the Indian origin Canadian politician who has been appointed as a new defense minister of Canada. So recently the new defense minister of Canada was appointed and she is Indian origin. Her name is Anita Anand. This question is that the chances of this question is very high in your NDA examination. Moving over to the next question. Name the inventor of contact lens who was honored by the Google Doodle on his 108th birthday on 27th of October 2021. Then answer is Otto Wichterle. You have to remember this name, Otto Wichterle. Moving over to the next question. Which space agency is preparing to launch the DART mission to prevent the collision of Earth with an asteroid using the kinetic impactor technique? Then it is the US Space Agency of NASA, which is preparing to launch the DART mission to prevent the collision of Earth and asteroid. Moving over to the next question. Which country has become the second one in the world after China to administer the 100 crore doses of COVID-19 vaccine on 21st of October 2021. So India became the second country after China to administer 100 crore vaccine to the population of India, and it is a great achievement for our country. Moving over to the next question. On which day International Day for Eradication of Poverty was observed? So on 17th of October, Eradication Day of Poverty was observed. On 9th of Jan, Pravasi Bharatiya Divas is observed. This question is also important because on this day only Mahatma Gandhi returned from South Africa in the year 1950. So we celebrate Pravasi Bharatiya Divas on 9th of Jan only. Moving over to the next question. What is the title recently released autobiography of the former PepsiCo CEO Indra Nooyi? So basically they are asking what is the autobiography of Indra Nooyi. Then the answer is My Life in Full. My Life in Full is an autobiography of Indra Nooyi. This question you have to remember. Moving over to the next question. On which day World Food Day was observed? World Food Day was observed on 16th of October. Next question is, which country has topped the Global Food Security Index 2021 followed by Australia and UK? So the Global Food Security Index, already I told you the rank of India was 71st and the first rank was given to Ireland. Moving over to the next question. On which day World Statistics Day is observed? World Statistics Day is observed on 20th of October and UN Day is observed on 24th of October. National Consumer Day is observed on 24th of October. Moving over to the next question, which is appearing on your screen. Next question is also very much important. Like, Curtis Kemper has become the third bowler in the T20 history to take 4 wickets in 4 consecutive bowl after Lasith Malinga and Rashid Khan. He plays for which team? He plays for Ireland. His name
कुर्टिस कैम्पर बिकेम द थर्ड बॉलर इन द T20 टू टेक 4 कंसेक्यूटिव विकेट्स इन 4 कंसेक्यूटिव बॉल. दिस क्वेश्चन बिकम्स इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम द स्पोर्ट्स पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. नेक्स्ट ऑन योर स्क्रीन, ऑन विच डे इंटरनेशनल डे ऑफ गर्ल चाइल्ड इज ऑब्जर्व. इंटरनेशनल डे ऑफ गर्ल चाइल्ड इज ऑब्जर्व ऑन 11th ऑफ अक्टूबर. दिस क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम इंपॉर्टेंट डेज एंड इवेंट्स इट बिकम्स इंपॉर्टेंट. मूविंग ओवर टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, हु वॉज सोन इन एज द न्यू चांसलर ऑफ ऑस्ट्रेलिया. सो द न्यू चांसलर ऑफ ऑस्ट्रेलिया इज अलेक्जेंड्रा सेस्लाबेर आफ्टर एंजेला मर्केल. मूविंग ओवर टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच टू कंट्री टॉप द हेनले पासपोर्ट इंडेक्स 2021 विद देयर पासपोर्ट होल्डर्स बींग अलाउड टू विजिट 192 कंट्रीज. देन जापान एंड सिंगापुर पासपोर्ट इज द स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट पासपोर्ट इन एंटायर कंट्री एंड द रैंक ऑफ इंडिया इज 883 इन द हेनले पासपोर्ट रैंकिंग इंडेक्स 2022. मूविंग ओवर टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच कंपनी हैज़ लॉन्च द स्टारलिंक सेटेलाइट इंटरनेट सर्विस. स्टारलिंक सेटेलाइट इंटरनेट सर्विस इज लॉन्च बाई अमेरिकन बेस्ड प्राइवेट स्पेस कंपनी स्पेस एक्स. द फाउंडर ऑफ स्पेस एक्स इज एलन मस्क. एलन मस्क इज ऑल्सो द फाउंडर ऑफ ऑटोमोबाइल कंपनी नोन एज टेस्ला. मूविंग ओवर टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, हु इज द सीईओ ऑफ स्पेस एक्स. सीईओ ऑफ स्पेस एक्स इज एलन मस्क. ऑलरेडी आई टोल्ड यू. ऑन विच डे वर्ल्ड पोस्ट डे वॉज ऑब्जर्व. इट वॉज ऑब्जर्व ऑन 9th ऑफ अक्टूबर, वर्ल्ड पोस्ट डे. Moving over to the next question, which country has unveiled the world's first automated and driverless train? So the first country to unveil the world's first automated and driverless train is the country of Germany, and the capital of Germany is Berlin. Moving over to the next question, name the nuclear scientist from Pakistan who passed away at the age of 85 after a brief illness on 10th of October 2021. He was known as father of Pakistan nuclear program. So the nuclear scientist name was Dr. Abdul Qadir Khan. Abdul Qadir Khan was known as father of Pakistan nuclear program. Next question is, on which day World Cotton Day is observed? World Cotton Day is observed on 7th of October every year, and World Teacher Day is observed on 5th of October. See, here you should know the difference between the World Teacher Day and Teacher Day in India. In India, Teacher Day is observed on 5th of September, but in whole world, Teacher Day is observed on 5th of October. Moving over to the next question, who has succeeded Mr. Yoshihide Suga as the new Prime Minister of Japan on October 4, 2021? The new Prime Minister of Japan is Fumio Kishida. Fumio Kishida is the name of new Prime Minister of Japan. Moving over to the next question. Now the question related to the Nobel Prize will come. And Nobel Prize, it is given only once in a year in the field of economics, in the field of medicine, physics, chemistry, literature and peace. That means in 6 fields, Nobel Prize is given, and it was started in the year 1901. And the first Indian to get Nobel Prize was Sri Rabindranath Tagore for his book Gitanjali. So basically, we will start with the Nobel Prize which was given in the year 2021. So who won Nobel Prize in literature for 2021 for his uncompromising and compassionate penetration of the effect of colonialism and the fate for his refugee in the Gulf between the culture and continent? Then answer is Abdul Gurnah. Abdul Razzaq Gurnah is the name of the person who won Nobel Prize 2021 in the field of literature. Moving over to the next question, who won the Nobel Peace Prize 2021 for their effort to safeguard freedom of expression, which is precondition for democracy and lasting peace? So basically, they are asking who won Nobel Peace Prize 2021. Then two person won, that is Maria Ressa and Dmitry Muratov. Maria Ressa and Dmitry Muratov, these both are the person who won Nobel Peace Prize in 2021. So the next question which is appearing on your screen is, who won 2021 Nobel Prize in the field of chemistry for developing new tools for building molecules that have helped in making new drugs and are more environmental friendly? Then the name is Benjamin List and David W.C. Macmillan. These both are the person who won 2021 Nobel Prize in the field of chemistry. Next question is, who won Nobel Prize in the field of medicine for discovering on receptor for temperature and touch? Then the two person are
डेविड जूलियस एंड एडम पाटापोटियन. दिस बोथ आर द नेम्स. यू कैन जस्ट टेक अ स्क्रीन शॉट और यू कैन जस्ट राइट डाउन द नेम्स ऑफ दिस टू पर्सन्स. मूविंग ओवर टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, हु वन नोबेल प्राइज इन द फील्ड ऑफ फिजिक्स. नेम इज सुकालो मनाबे एंड क्लॉस हसलमैन एंड जियोगो पारिसी. दीज थ्री साइंटिस्ट वन नोबेल प्राइज इन द फील्ड ऑफ फिजिक्स एंड इन द फील्ड ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स. थ्री पर्सन वन दे आर डेविड कार्ड, जोसुआ डी एंड ग्रिस्ट एंड गुआडो डब्ल्यू इम्बेंस. दीज थ्री आर द पर्सन हु वन नोबेल प्राइज इन द फील्ड ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स. मूविंग ओवर टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वेन इज वर्ल्ड टीचर डे इज ऑब्जर्व. वर्ल्ड टीचर डे इज ऑब्जर्व ऑन 5th of October एंड इन इंडिया टीचर डे इज ऑब्जर्व ऑन 5th of September. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज ऑन विच डे वर्ल्ड हैबिटेट डे इज ऑब्जर्व. वर्ल्ड हैबिटेट डे इज ऑब्जर्व ऑन 4th of October. सो फ्रेंड्स, लास्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ द डे इज ऑन विच डे इंटरनेशनल डे ऑफ नॉन वायलेंस वॉज ऑब्जर्व. सो ऑन 2nd of October इंटरनेशनल डे ऑफ नॉन वायलेंस इज ऑब्जर्व एवरी ईयर. वाई 2nd October वॉज चोजन? बिकॉज दिस इज द बर्थ एनिवर्सरी ऑफ महात्मा गांधी. सो 2nd October इज ऑब्जर्व एज इन इंटरनेशनल डे ऑफ नॉन वायलेंस डे. सो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज द एंड ऑफ द वीडियो. आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू एंजॉयड द वीडियो. प्लीज प्रेस द लाइक बटन इफ यू लाइक द वीडियो एंड इफ यू लाइक द कंटेंट प्लीज पुट योर थॉट्स इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. एंड विथ विच वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द पार्ट वन ऑफ द करंट अफेयर्स. स्टिल इफ यू वॉन्ट मोर करंट अफेयर्स ऑफ पार्ट टू, पार्ट थ्री, पार्ट फोर, वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट द एंटायर करंट अफेयर्स ऑफ NDA एंड CDS इन अराउंड 7 to 8 parts. And today was the part one. Subscribe the channel, share the channel to all of your friends, because we are going to cover all current affairs for your NDA and CDS examination. So friends, thank you friends for tuning till the end. Thank you, Jay.